Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by RoboJax. In this lecture, we are going to see how we can use and measure the temperature and humidity using DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. This is the DHT11 as it is sold with 4 pence, and this is the module that is made for Arduino with a little PCB here. This has 3 pence and this has 4 pence. The module also sold this way with 2 resistors on this side and 1 LED. This is a power LED, but usage of all of them will be the same, except you have to pay attention to the pins here. VCC data, this is the output, and the ground is on the other side, while in this one the plus is on the other side, VCC, and ground or negative is on this side. If we face in a situation that the wires from here to Arduino is less than 20 meters, which is most of the cases, we have to put extra resistor on the path from here, from this pin 2, to the positive. This module with a PCB already has the resistor in here. This module also has a resistor, and the second resistor is for the LED. This is the DHT11 humidity temperature data sheet. I will provide you the link, but a quick review shows that this can measure from 0 to 50 degrees Celsius. That is the limitation you have to know, and the relative humidity percent is between 20 to 90%, and relative humidity percent accuracy is ±5%, which means it can show incorrect or fluctuate 5% up, 5% down, and the temperature measurement also could be ±2 degrees Celsius. And here is the wiring diagram here from the datasheet. This is microcontroller unit, and this is a sensor. You have to connect from the left pin 1 to VDD. In our case, we will connect it to 5 volts. Pin 2 is the output, but from this pin also we connect 5 to 10 kilo ohm resistor. This is called pull-up resistor to 5 volts, and pin 3 is not used. Pin 4 is connected to the ground. Here is the wiring diagram. The first pin from the right have been connected using this black wire to the ground. The second pin is not connected. The third pin, which is the output, have been connected to pin 2. The first pin have been connected via this red wire to this line, which is connected to 5 volts. From this 5 volts, which we have here, a 10 kilo ohm resistor is connected here, which has been connected via a wire to pin 2. What it means is pin 2 have been connected to the positive via a 10 kilo ohm resistor. And here is wiring for the module. This pin have been connected to Arduino from this side, which I will show you. This is the second pin from the left. I've been connected to pin 2 here to Arduino. The blue, the black have been connected in here. And from pin 5 volts, this red has been connected to this line. And from here, we have this wire have been connected to pin 1. And from pin 2, this wire is connected in here. And with this 10 kilo ohm resistor have been connected to 5 volts. This is a 10 kilo ohm brown, black, orange resistor. Not critical, you can put 5 kilo ohm up to 20 kilo ohm will work fine. And here is a wiring diagram for the DHT11 with PCB module. From the right, this pin have been connected to ground, the middle pin have been connected to pin 2, and the pin on the left have been connected to 5 volts. And as you can see here, the right pin with this black wire have been connected to ground, The middle pin is the output. This has been connected to pin 2, and the pin on the left one is connected to 5 volts. Let me now explain the code. The first line starts with including DHT11.h. This is a header file. I will provide you the link to download it, and this is the actual link that I've pegged it from GitHub. And then after this, we use this class name, which is here. We create an instance. We call it DHT11. That's capital. And this object is used throughout the code. Then we define DHT pin, pin 2, which I'm using for the input. For the setup, we just initialize serial monitor with 9600 baud to display the text for us on the screen, the temperature. Inside the loop, we use DHT11.read and we pass the pin number. This reads the value, and once to get the humidity, we type DHT11.humidity, and this will give us the actual value. You can print directly using serial monitor. But if you want to do some calculation, or if you want to manipulate it later, you can store it in another variable. And this will be easier to handle than this, because this is longer with a dot. Then we can use this. Same way, we can do DHT11.temperature. This will get the temperature. And here, this is called casting. Inside opening and closing parenthesis, we put the type float. Because we put here float, this will convert this to float here in a new variable called temp of type float. Now we have temperature and humidity. Then we use a serial parent to parent the temperature, and then we put the C as a Celsius. We put space, you see, double quote, so these are our own text. And then inside this code, we put space. After the Celsius, we put humidity, the text. And after that, we put actual humidity that we measured here. Humidity with percent, and then new line. Then we wait 500 milliseconds, and the loop continues like that. Here is a demonstration. The module has been connected, it's powered up. Serial monitor is open. As you can see, it shows temperature. This is the temperature in Celsius, and we put the C. This is a C, space, this is a space, one space, another space here, and then humidity 18%, and then we have a new line here. And now I'm going to apply heat using this heat gun from Canadian Tire. You pay attention to the temperature that it increases here. As you can see, the temperature has increased here, but because the maximum is 50, it shows up to 59. Now, this has to get cooled down until the temperature goes within the range, so this can display it. And also, this is the humidity. Let's wait for this. And as you can see, the temperature is now slowly decreasing. The reason we are not getting decimal point, because the resolution is 1 degree. Here in the datasheet, it shows the resolution is 1 degree, and every time the temperature changes, it jumps with 1 degree. Now, if I remove this, you can see that this shows continuously for a while the incorrect value until I close this and open it again. Now it shows zero because there is no data coming from here. We'll insert this module, even though we have a resistor. Let's see, it will work with the same code and the same wiring. Except because this has 3 pin, this is now not connected. I have to move it to the next pin. And as you can see, it shows now the temperature. created this function called getTemp, and you just define the type that you want. For example, if your type can be F, you can put C for Celsius, F for Fahrenheit, K for Kelvin, and you can get all the values, whichever value you need it. You just pass it and it will return as a type float. Here we get a temperature, it's stored here as Celsius, and we check if type is F. We check it, this is character type. Then what we do is we get the temperature that have been calculated, we multiply it by 1.8 plus 32, which will convert it to Fahrenheit and return it back. If the type is K, Kelvin, then we have to add 274.15 on top of Celsius, else return the original value, which is a Celsius. Now, this is the code that is using the function that I have written at the bottom. To read the temperature, just say get temp temperature with capital T, and inside this single code, which is a character, just pass C for Celsius, F for Fahrenheit, and K for Kelvin, and it will give you the temperature, as I'm going to show you now. It shows a value here. And to get Fahrenheit, you will get the Fahrenheit, and the same way Kelvin. And here I've used multiple lines of the same code, get temp and then Celsius, and I'm putting the capital C, and then Fahrenheit, capital F, that's the text, and then Kelvin, capital K, and then humidity, and then percent, a new line, and the code continues. And once the code is loaded, this is how it shows: 35 degrees Celsius, 95 degrees Fahrenheit, 309.15 degrees Kelvin, and then humidity as 10%, all in one line. It continuously reset. Let me apply some heat with heat gun. And here are the values in Fahrenheit, Kelvin, and Celsius. This was the lecture of introduction to DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. Thank you for watching. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates on my upcoming videos.